We're back on Wake Up Today. It is, let's see, 6:24 on this Monday morning. And every Monday, we get a chance to ask a specialist from the Queens Medical Center. I want to welcome in Dr. Cedric Lorenzo. He's the director of the Queens Weight Management Program. Now, this is a perfectly timed segment because January tends to be, a lot of us have New Year's resolutions, mm-hmm. and a lot of it deals with weight.
Yes.
Some of the benefits, health benefits, that can be improved or maybe even cured if you manage your weight properly.
That's very, it's a very good time to lose weight. Mm-hmm. It's a new year, new resolutions, like you said. If anyone wants to and just loses about 10% of their total body weight, many illnesses such as high blood pressure, diabetes, sleep apnea, where they snore and have a difficult time getting restful sleep, should get better. Even walking and physically doing things will get better because you get rid of the pressure that's on your knees. And it just makes you feel better overall. So we're encouraging everybody to start looking at their health, their eating, and making changes to improve their health.
What are some changes? What are some things we could do? I mean, you're not necessarily asking everybody to go run a marathon or do something like mm-hmm. that, or an Ironman. Mm-hmm. Some of the things that you could do to improve your health.
There's a few things that people can do. I'm carrying with me what's called a pedometer. And it's a very simple, inexpensive device. You can even download pedometers on your smartphone. And what people can do is be mindful of how many steps they take every day. When someone walks less than 5,000 steps, they're considered sedentary, or couch potato, right? If you walk at least 10,000 steps every day, you'll be able to sort of neutralize the amount of calories you typically would be eating. And so we encourage everybody to take the opportunity to walk. Park a little bit farther if you have to. Take the stairs instead of the elevators. Walk over to the next desk instead of asking the courier to, you know, walk it over. So just getting more activity. And by using a pedometer, you'll be able to monitor your steps and then kind of, you know, walk faster if you have to, or walk more.
10,000 sounds like a lot. Is that a lot? I mean, are we talking miles of walking?
It's about 5 miles. But if you think about it, that's going to be the steps you do from the moment you wake up to the moment you go to bed. So you can get a lot of activity in that period of time.
And when you run to the grocery store, a lot of times there are a lot of open parking spots. Mm-hmm. If you take the very first one, mm-hmm. and there you go, you're adding a few more steps.
That's right. Yep.
Okay. On extreme measures, because mm-hmm. we do have some who are probably who you would consider obese. Mm-hmm. What about bariatric surgery? Who should consider that?
Bariatric surgery would be considered for someone who's tried multiple attempts at weight loss using so-called conventional methods, diet, exercise, medications, over-the-counter medications, or those that are prescribed. If someone has tried multiple attempts but has had also issues with their health, those that we mentioned, the diabetes, the high blood pressure, etc., then bariatric surgery becomes something that they should consider. It's a proven way of durable weight loss. Most people will lose about a third of what they currently weigh after bariatric surgery. And the good thing is that about 68 to 70% of people can keep it off for the rest of their life and stay healthy.
All right. Dr. Cedric Lorenzo, he's with the Queens Medical Center. Thank you so much. We appreciate that.
Thank you.